This is a 2020 Corolla Hybrid spark plugs. 10 millimeter to remove the coil flex. Been over 100,000 miles since the plugs were changed. Just try to be very careful. Got this from AutoZone, 9/16. You see that? It's 9/16. Duralast magnetic. It's gonna be oil on the plug. Counterclockwise. Loose, so what I'm gonna do is a little drill. See that spark plug adapter? Oh, need the extension. Spark plug adapter, extension. Screw it out. Get some help. Slowly. Oh, I want to see some oil on here. I'll be surprised. Okay, no oil. It says over 100,000 miles on it. It was misfiring yesterday for about 10 seconds. Then it normalized. So we're probably going to see, engine light didn't come on. We're probably going to see something on one of the plugs that's going to look unusual or not. And these were Autolite XP5684. No, we're in here. I believe these were from Advance Auto. And the ones I have are from Advance Auto also. Putting in. We're gonna have anti-seize lubricant. I'll be putting a little on. Doesn't need much. I don't remember if I put anti-seize on those on the ones I just took out. Not sure. These are the new ones. Come on now, focus. Focus. It's focusing on the car. but I can see a different, definitely a difference in the electrode. You can easily tell which one's the new one, which one's the old one. Alright, so we may see the spark plug getting progressively worse as we go down the line. We'll see, we may see some oil. Put a little there. And I'm gonna put it back on inside. It's magnetic. See there. Put it back in. This is the new one. Still getting about high 40s miles per gallon on this thing. It says 50. I always reduce it a few miles per gallon. From all the measurements, I know it's, you know, those readings aren't perfect. And we're gonna ease it in clockwise, so that just comes in handy. Universal joint. Ease it down. I'm actually gonna turn it by hand first. Call. On. Slowly. See that. I'll do it till it stops. And it stopped. So we need to take the power off. Snug torque spec here, don't use, it's so important. All right, first one is complete. Coil, 455,000 miles, still running, original, made in Japan, yeah. It's a little more difficult because it's near harness. Click. It's pressed all the way down. You really don't hear any click when it clicks onto the top of the spark plug. But it's down there. And we'll definitely know when it starts up. If you did it right. Clockwise, back on the other way. Down, snug it. So I don't want to break that off. Okay. Off to the second one. Inch. My impacts are half inch. fun at 1,000 miles of this thing. You wanna very ginger. I'll show you each one. As you can see, the rust. Maybe see it on you too. Still no oil. I think it's, there has to be oil because I remember doing it last time and I put up a little bit of oil because the vodka of the gaskets, the spark plug guide seals are failing. They've never been done. Should be. I would expect them to be leaking. Plug. Landing seats. I don't think I put anti seats. I don't want to take out. Probably be the last set of plugs for this car. Put you back in. My hand first. Then I'm gonna screw it down and then back the hand. Sealed itself, huh? There's definitely oil coming off of some of these plugs. Last time I did this, just want to put it together. I'm not going to tighten it down until we're done. Yeah. flathead screwdriver to pull it off a little. Tab is up. It's fighting me a little bit. It's moving. I hear it clicking. Tab. Tab came out with it, so we're just going to try to slide that back on exactly. That's what we're going to do. We're not going to even mess with it. I'm going to slide that back on exactly. All right, we're going to do the plug first. Let's just get this one, and that may happen because you know. Maybe I should have lubricated these electrical contacts. So that goes to show, if you know, you should lubricate these contacts. Not all of them. Certain electrical contacts you don't lubricate. This plug, counterclockwise. Oh, here's some rust breaking. Alright, it's loose. Pull it out with a little bit of power. A little slow. Counterclockwise. Assistance. Sounds a little seized. This might be the one with the oil on it. Alright, let's try it again. Counterclockwise. Over 100,000 miles since the last one. There we go. All right. So hope that electrical connection goes back the way it's supposed to. I'm gonna have to get my pick some small, thin flatheads that I'm sure I can repair it. But we're just gonna try to slide that electrical connector back on the way it came off. Hopefully it will work out. I'm not buying a, well, that's the, that's on the harness. Let's see what happens. Lubricant, anti-seize. Caught.
pressure. It stops.
I'm sure I could just take it out and bind it, put it back onto the electrical connector that came out with it. But I'm going to just try to slide it directly back in how it came off. Exactly. Not, I'm gonna take it out and screw it back. Yeah, I'm gonna have to. Yeah. I'm gonna take that out. Alright. It's annoyance, but let's go to the next plug. That came out with it. That goes on this. That goes onto the inner wiring harness. So I have to pull that out and stick that back into the wiring harness plug. Back into that. Sure, I still need a valve cover gasket though. It's been a while, but well, I wasn't running the engine for that long. It is slightly warm. It's not really warm. It's on a colder side. And it's mostly cold. Last one, then we gotta deal with that coil back. Third one. Time. This is number 4. Super rust. I bought a precision like screwdriver set, so let's see. Pair a third one with that. Grab that. It's gonna be a little difficult to show. That's the problem. I'm gonna pull that out. This is what I have. I believe I bought these specifically for connectors. This is a kit. And I have these, you know, picks and different degree angles of picks. So it's band out. I can see that. This band. I've done this before. Yeah, okay, I see. Now that plastic, I have to pull that plastic out the center, and that plastic goes back into the connector with this band around it. Alright. So maybe a hook. Let me try this first. Let me enhance that a little bit. Let's see. All right, so first I'm just going to try to press against the side and pull it out. And if that doesn't work, then I'm going to get like a hook, one with like a, not a 90 degree, but just below a 90 degree. And pull it out. And it's dry now. I don't want to destroy it trying to take it out either, because then I think I'm kind of screwed. This is the connector. It's not the coil. I can replace the coil. The connector, I don't know if I can't replace that. So I can't break this. I can't think it's moving. I want to be very, very careful. Might try the hook. If this is going to move, it's going to move. Don't want to destroy the different surfaces, the lips that are inside. Don't want to destroy that even more. Let's try the hook. And if they were just seized together so it stayed in. Could add some lubricant to it. That's moving. It's moving. I could try to pull right here too. I don't want to snap anything. Let's what do I have in there? Try this thicker one. It's real time. I may just get something to pull on these, but I don't want to snap anything when I pull it. I can get something to pull in there very gently, ease it out. It's moving. It's moving. Some needle nose. Yeah, I mean. Oh. Okay. All right. Alright, so we gotta put the orange band back around this. And there is a lip, so I think I can put this on backwards. I don't think it's really that critical. I believe this still makes it water resistant. And I believe this is only goes on the outside of the band. It goes on the outside. Let me check. Let's check back on the car. I have to put that on the connector. So I have to put the orange band on the connector. Let's go over there, back to the car. Okay, I'm looking at the second one. See the orange band in the back, and I see that white connector piece go in front. So I believe I have to slip that band on first, and the connector piece on second. Let's do that. See that? I don't know how much you're gonna be able to see. First, I think you just slide the connector over it. The center piece of the connector. I don't know which way it goes. It goes like that. This one looks from the back. Alright. Three. Up there is three. You are on four. Now, I'm trying to figure out which way this goes. So, let's stare at it for a little while. You don't want to crush this. This part goes down. Okay. See that? That goes down. So you will put it on. You can see that. These fins. It's like the landing on the bottom goes on the bottom where it's more open. Top goes up top, okay? It goes on like that. Hope you get what I'm saying. kind of see it. Yeah, you can see the three. And they slide right on. Yeah, hopefully that connects. Let me try to connect it. If I didn't damage anything. And it clicked. Okay. Let's see if it'll come off.
Right.
And that came right back out. Okay. Now we can just pull it out with the needle nose. Alright, so let's see. Well, I didn't really put any pressure on it. Maybe it's supposed to click. Let's try it again. It's a good note. 455,000 miles. So. By the way, it's electrically connected. So now I did see some orange coming out of here. You should be able to see that on the camera. See some orange? Yeah, you see it. Yeah, you see some orange coming out of there. So we're gonna take that apart and push the orange, seat the orange. Well, it's deformed actually, because probably last time I did it, I didn't seat that orange band correctly. So you can close the orange in this one here. So take that apart. Let's try. Yep, just loose and pulling it straight out. Okay. I think I'm broke, because I don't know if this thing breaks. I don't know how. Replace this. I'm sure I can get away without putting the band on, but this right here, I don't know. I lose this, and then I'm screwed. All right, let's put this down somewhere. That one won't fall, and it looked like the orange band. We hold it with two hands, held its shape. So we're gonna seat that correctly the best way we can. The other two are seated correctly. Let's seat this correctly. You're going to need some type of picks and precision tool to get this on, or very steady hand. Make this seat it correctly. Yep. So you need the right tools, especially when you run into little issues like this. You know, sometimes it's straightforward and sometimes it's, you know, a little nuance. But let's see the whole thing. I'm not gonna pause it. This is sometimes the difficulty of working on cars. This is why you gotta charge appropriately. Sometimes things aren't straightforward. So, to avoid problems in the future, you wanna make sure you get take care of little issues like this. All right, we got it. Now I'm gonna push it back. correctly. Sure you're getting me, all right? Seat it back. And critical thinking is definitely a plus. And asking for help. Asking for help if it's available. But as a mobile mechanic, you're pretty much all there is. And I'm gonna do the same thing here. Fins are gonna go down. You can see that. It's gonna go down, and the open area up here is the top. So just like that. And we're not gonna try to plug it in and take it out again, because it's probably gonna come out. Over time, you know, heating up, cooling down, heating up, cooling down. They're not as tight as it used to be. I'm sure they're just supposed to just click in. You can see it there. But the third one didn't. I put it on, took the coil pack off, and it came right out again. So. Grabbing a little bit. All right. Yes, I'm just gonna just mate them on. Appears to be on there correctly. It's number three, and this is number four. All right. So we have four spark plugs here. One, two, three, four. And we have four empty boxes. And we'll know when we're started up. We have four plugs in there. All right, these are the four of them. All right. Let's tighten it down. Let's plug number two in. Heard it. Alright. Number four. See the rust. See that. But original. Original coil. Coil. Coils. That connector looks good. Alright. I think last time I did this, I didn't have the proper picks and degree turns on these. That's why it looked like that. I did the best I could. And I probably had flathead screwdriver or something like that. And that clipped. And it's all together. Screw them down. And organize my tools. No, I'm gonna start off first. Organize the tools. Make sure we didn't screw up anything. It's seized to the bolt. This is a 10 millimeter. Let's tie it down. Now this, since this is lacks power, we can just kind of tap it on there. I've got to do it with my hand. Trigger, turn it.
Better on.
Okay. Jesus.
Get this fire up.
Fish fires up.
Show you the mileage.
Well, job well done.
Show you the mileage.
There we go, 456,167.
Spark plugs, 2020 little hybrid, and solving a few problems at the same time. All right, please like and subscribe.